Hey friends, on a recent episode of Azure Friday, we talked about how you can significantly reduce costs with Azure Reserved VM Instances. SUSE is back to update us on Reserved VM Instance size flexibility and has important news to share about new ways that you can save money with Azure SQL Databases, Cosmos DB, and on SUSE VMs too today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with SUSE, who's coming back to share more cool stuff happening with Azure Reservations. You saved me money last time. You're going to save me even more money right now, and hopefully save some money for the folks that are watching the show.
Absolutely, and make your reservation management much easier.
Really? Excellent.
Yes. So last time we spoke about how Azure Reservations, VM Reservations, can save you money.
Mm-hmm.
Since then, we've been busy working on new features. One feature that we have just recently launched is instance size flexibility.
Mm.
What that does is, if you buy a reservation for size, let's say F1,
okay,
but you later your needs change and you move to a F2 VM,
mm-hmm,
your reservation will automatically apply to F2. You don't have to go return that reservation and rebuy something else.
Okay, and I don't have to, you know, delete in VMs and assign reservations. I just go from a 2-seater car to a 4-seater car.
Yeah.
And I assume if I double the size of my VM, then the reservation is proportional?
Yes. So the reservation applies in the ratio of the VM's pricing.
Mm.
So I have the chart here. So F1 mm-hmm to F2 ratio is 1:2. So
okay,
if you buy one F1, but you later, let's say, move to F2 VM, half of it is going to be reserved, and mm-hmm other half is going to be charged on demand.
So I see. So if I had two F1s, As reserved, I could move to an F2, and that would go straight across.
That'll just totally zero out your F2 usage. You won't have to pay anything on demand.
Well, that's comforting, because now people don't have to have that sense of like, yeah, I want to commit to 3 years.
Yeah.
I know I'll be using compute. I just don't know what size I'll be using for the next 3 years.
Yes, and now it's totally flexible within the VM size group.
That's fantastic, and people already get this. Even people with existing reservations have this benefit.
People with existing reservations have this benefit. And if you had a single scoped reservation earlier, you can go change it to instance size flexibility from capacity priority and start getting this benefit.
Very cool. Yeah.
So that's the first thing I wanted to share out. Here's the UI. So I selected a data center East US. I selected F1 series here. And here's the instance size flexibility option.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you in the UI that this reservation discount will apply to F1, F2, F4, F8, or F16,
mm-hmm,
which are the VMs in the same VM size group, and the ratio is available here. So you can just go get all the information that you need and confidently buy this reservation.
Okay.
So that's the first thing that we just recently launched. The next thing that we have been busy with is expanding reservations to other products on Azure.
Mm.
So besides VM, we also have reservations available for SQL now, and Cosmos DB, and SUSE Linux.
Nice. This is going to be huge for people that are using these products, because I assume that if they're watching right now, they're using this product already, they could pause this episode of Azure Friday and immediately start saving money for real.
Yes, absolutely. You can buy a reservation right now and start saving money on SQL, Cosmos, SUSE also.
Awesome.
So this is the SQL purchase experience.
Okay.
It's very simple. You just have to go select the data center.
Mm-hmm.
And then what general purpose or business critical, and the generation of the SQL that you use. You don't have to pick a SQL database. We will just automatically give you the discount.
Okay, so to be clear, if someone is watching the show right now, they're using the SQL PaaS, right, the SQL as a service, and they're paying full price, but they know they're going to be using it for a year, 2 years, 3 years, they could go and set up a reservation, and they don't need to move the database, transfer, move things around. As long as the region is in the right place,
yeah,
it will automatically apply.
It's a billing benefit. You don't have to do anything with your resources. You don't have to touch your resources. We will automatically apply the reservation discount on your SQL instance at the time of billing.
That's super useful. So it's a billing benefit. Really important thing to remember. They don't have to restart anything or move anything around. And they're going to save like huge amounts. You can see there at the bottom, it actually calculates the percentage.
Yes. So this is the saving on your compute usage for SQL.
Mm-hmm.
You can save up to 55% here on this configuration.
So when people use SQL, they're billed for the compute of SQL, which they can save huge amounts on. And then, of course, there's the SQL license cost. How can people save money on that?
Yeah, so for license cost, you can use Azure Hybrid Benefits.
Okay.
If you have a license with Software Assurance mm-hmm in your enterprise contract,
right,
you can just use that on your SQL PaaS deployment and then save on the IP also.
Okay, so if I have a SQL server running under my desk,
yes,
and I then buy a reserved one and I move it up into the cloud, I can turn off the one under my desk and move that license into the cloud.
Yes, you can totally do that. And here, you can increase your savings up to 80% by doing that.
Really? So the hybrid benefit gets me even more benefits, yeah, and even cheaper price with reservations.
Yeah, so you combine reservations with hybrid benefits to get your discount percentage up to 80%.
80%. Okay, cool. And this is really important. Like, you can do this right now. You may be putting money away that you don't need to. That's fantastic.
You can do this right now on SQL. You can do this right now on Windows VMs also.
Seriously? So the hybrid benefit works on Windows VMs as well?
On Windows VM and SQLs. I'll put the link with the video for the hybrid use benefits also.
Fantastic.
Yes, so that's another thing that we just recently launched.
Mm-hmm.
As I said, we've been working on other ways also to save money, and Cosmos DB is a new reservation offering.
Mm.
If you use Cosmos DB, mm-hmm, you can go buy reservations for Cosmos DB also and then start saving money on that as well.
Nice.
Yeah, and the way Cosmos DB works is the reservation discount changes, mm-hmm, by how much you commit to reserve.
Right.
The capacity that you reserve. If you reserve 100K per hours, mm-hmm, per hour, RUs per second,
mm-hmm,
you get about 30% discount. If your usage is more,
mm-hmm,
let's say a 1 million RU per second per hour usage, and you buy a reservation, your discount goes up to, in this case, 40%.
So the more you use, the more you save.
Yeah, so the more you use, the more you can commit here and, mm-hmm, and start just saving more and more on Cosmos DB as well going forward.
Nice.
And the last thing that we have been working on and we just recently launched is SUSE Linux software purchase, mm-hmm, discounts. So if you have any SUSE VMs, you can purchase software, pre-purchase software for that also and then save money. You can save up to 64% on your SUSE software and support part.
And just as you said before, if I understand correctly, this is again a billing benefit. So you may be watching this video, you may already have SUSE VMs.
Yeah.
You can apply this now,
yes,
save money now.
Yeah.
How can I make sure I'm saving the right money? Some of us run billing reports and we bring those things into Excel. We look at the billing APIs. I want to make sure that the benefit that I paid for, that the reservation I paid for got applied to the resource I expected it to be applied to.
Yeah, so you can, there's two ways. You can look at your reservation after the purchase,
okay,
and it'll show you the utilization percentage.
Okay.
So let's say your reservation was used 50% or 100%, it'll tell you there itself.
Okay.
The other thing that you can do is you can look at your usage file,
okay,
and in the usage file, we will tell you how the reservation was applied. So I have a sample here. I have a VM running, and in this VM, I zero out the resource rate.
Mm.
I replace the regular meter with the reservation-based VM meter here,
okay,
which is priced at $0. So you're not charged for this VM anymore,
mm-hmm,
on a day-to-day basis. And all the details as to which reservation applied on this VM is in the usage file itself, the file and the API that you consume on a daily basis for your cost management reports.
Okay. So you can definitely make sure that you don't make any mistakes and that you get the benefits that you paid for. You can see clearly where the reservation order ID has been applied to that virtual machine.
Yes. You can get the reservation order ID, reservation ID, and you can get the consumption meter also that we zeroed out for this reservation benefit.
Mm-hmm. And if you wouldn't mind, show me in the portal where I would find this. I noticed that there was a reservations area in the portal that gives me all of these details in one single place.
Yes. So in the portal, you can go to the reservations blade here.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll show you all your existing reservations.
So this is where I would go to see my existing reservations as well as make new ones.
Yes, you can see the utilization, you can see the region and the SKUs that were purchased.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to purchase a new one, you just click on add and you get all the options to purchase.
So since I saw you last, you've already added these things. I assume you're starting to look across Azure for other opportunities for everyone to save money with reservations.
Yes, we are looking at more and more services and getting more customer feedback as to how we can save more for them.
Cool. Well, I hope you come back when you've got more to share. That's fantastic.
Absolutely.
I'm saving all kinds of money with reservations here on Azure Friday.